out here in the pits of the National Hot Rod Association, and we found a really cool car. It's truck, it's car, it's Ford Ranchero, and this one won Best Appearing here at New England Dragway here with Angie Kinson. You won this award. This is a brand new car. We've got to check it out. Tell us about this machine.
Yeah, so this is 1965 Ford Ranchero. My father built the entire car from scratch. He bought the body out west, did a lot of body work, but then custom fabricated everything that you see. This is a full blown Dave Ray custom job right here.
Amazing stuff. Now, you say from scratch, like, was the plan, like, let's get a Ranchero. That seems like out of the middle of nowhere.
Yeah, so he loves the car, so he wanted, this is actually his daily street car. He drives it to work, physical therapy, grocery store, throwing all the groceries in the back of it, so he's just always been a fan of the Ranchero. So he thought, why not build one from scratch? And then we're in between motors right now. We usually race in top sportsmen, but we're, you know, with COVID and everything, it's been tough getting motor parts. So we thought we'd come out and race Super Street this weekend, and we're having a blast.
Oh, that is amazing. And I love Super Street. Everybody knows that. Show us a little bit around the car. The attention to detail, it is perfect. You can see that it is a street car, but also runs here in the NHRA. And that's what we want people to understand, that not every car that goes down the racetrack is only for drag racing.
Absolutely. You can see on the front, we actually have an actual street sticker on it and the license plate on the front. So it's fully registered, so you can drive it 100% on the street. It doesn't overheat, so you can do whatever you want with it. And if you feel like doing some burnouts maybe on the side of the road, you can do that too and have some fun.
We don't encourage that, folks. Definitely not. And the wheels too. Like the whole combination, the color, the look, the Ranchero, the lines. Everybody's seen an El Camino. The Ranchero is the less common Ford brother.
It is. So we brought it to Sean at Paintworks in Kingston, New Hampshire, and my father dropped it off and said, hey, I can't decide on a color, so pick a color. We had no idea what the color was going to be until we picked it up, and we were loving it as soon as we saw it. It was awesome.
We are all loving it. Can we see under the hood?
Of course you can.
All right. Yeah, everybody wants to know. That better not be a small block Chevrolet under the hood.
No, absolutely not. We are hardcore Ford fans. This is actually a Ford 514 in it, so we're, you know, just take it easy, but we're also having fun. It goes 130 flat out, so it's a very cool race car for us.
Yes, best ET in mile per hour, not on the throttle stop.
Not on the throttle stop, 10-10 at 132.
There you go. That's getting with it. And you can see, everybody, like the suspension work. This is a built car, not a lot left from the original, which is what makes it awesome.
Right. He even custom fabricated the whole front, the firewall, all the bars that you see, the springs, the suspension, everything he did on his own. He made everything. It is fantastic. It's been a privilege to bring it out here this weekend.
Yes, absolutely. Now, ultimately, we want to see and hear it run, but I've just got to admire it. All you Ford people out there, what do you think of this? The Ranchero, it is spectacular. And, you know, drag racing, the cars are great, but it's a way to showcase fabrication skills also.
Absolutely. I mean, this is, you know, he's been doing this for his whole life. He even built a Ford Bronco from scratch at home too, and that thing, you would drool over that, I promise.
I'm drooling over this. And you're a teacher, I understand.
I am, yeah. I teach 8th grade math at Timberlane in Plastow, so I'm very happy to represent teachers too.
Thank you for doing that. Can we see you in your classroom?
Why not?
Or in your office, rather? Yes, exactly. Angie gonna jump inside. She's turning on the power. That's usually my job, Angie, but that's okay.
Oh, sorry.
That's all right.
I'm very independent, you know?
Yes. It's so nice. Let's just observe this for a second. And this is the first Ranchero ever. Just making sure everything's right. Don't fire it up yet.
Walk us through what you do.
Well, yeah, exactly. Because
that's
the.
I'm excited.
Me too.
Okay.
That's the big finish, but I got other stuff to talk to you about.
Okay.
Take us through like a run. Like said, so this is, it's a street car, but
you
have set it up. Obviously, you got your digital delay and everything set up there. So walk everybody through what you do when you pull into the water box and make
so
a run.
Obviously, put it into gear, right? So I got everything on. I got a water pump, fuel pump, fan, ignition, fire it up. Then I have my delay box here. Make sure that's on. Otherwise, I'm going to be going full out. We don't want that. The goal is Super Street to run 1090. So do my burnout, right? Throw it in neutral, rev it up, make sure it's all clear, put it in low. And then I get up there, and I have my trans brake button right on the steering wheel, pump the brakes as hard as I can, push that trans brake button, and then I can just smash it to the floor. And when I see that Pro Tree light, I just let go of the button, and you can hear everything click and fire. That's the delay box turning on and off. I shift. I got a shift light here. When I see that bad boy, I'll hit it into high gear. Then we'll coast through and hopefully get the wind light.
That is awesome. All right, can we hear it run?
Let's hope.
Let's hope.
Woo!
the mufflers be?
Yeah, baby. 514.
We can continue to have a conversation. She's going to rev it up a little bit. Ranchero. Wow.
My favorite parts of the day is warming it up. I love it. I love the firing up. Gets you excited for the day, so it's very cool.
What's the reaction you get from the car?
It's just, you go into like a tunnel vision to really, you know, people ask like, what does it feel like? What's it like? Especially in my other car, you know, going 6 seconds at 240, like it's just a tunnel vision. You just go and you're like, man, that was just so exhilarating. It was so much fun. And you're just like, it gets you hooked up. Like you can't come out here one time and not want to come back.
Speaking of that, you know, this is a Super Street car, but I want to know about the ghost of Lebanon Valley.
Yeah, so we have a Ford Mustang, 65 more Ford Mustang at home. It used to be a Hemi powered, used to race in Pro Mod. So my fastest pass was a 588 at 240. So that was thrilling and that was fun. So we're slowing it down. We're getting a new motor, hopefully from John Kazi, and we can run in Top Sportsman next year.
She runs Top Sportsman. She runs Super Street, and she has a great time doing either. Thank you for sharing your vehicle with us.
Thank you. Thank you for having us.
And that's why you come out into the pits here at the National Hot Rod Association.